They say we are defined by how we perform with our backs against the wall. With the losing streak at 5, the Rush return home desperate for a final sprint to the final playoff spot. Each one as close to a must win as the next. It is officially the stretch run, and this is Inside the Rush. On this game week, Robert Church and Mark Matthews hopped on the plane to northern Saskatchewan, where Next Gen gave the guys a chance to hang out with the kids from Buffalo Narrows and maybe even a few future Rush.
Good, we got to introduce some people to lacrosse for the first time. Seems like there was a lot of interest, so. Yeah, it was a successful day. You know, they seemed to enjoy themselves, especially Bruiser, and then anytime they got to shoot the ball on us.
Back at the arena on Friday night, sharpshooter Robert Church struggled to score one for the mic.
I don't know if it's on yet. I'm mic'd up. I wanted to get you to say something stupid. What? You think you're probably one of the best shooters on the team?
Oh, I think you are.
You think you're the best defender to ever play the game of lacrosse?
No.
That's what I said. If I go up to him and say, how's your toe voice? He'll know right away. I went up to Martin, right? I just laughed. That's why you're one of the best. That's why you're one of the best. I'm only missing because this mic's affecting my back. Where are we going? Let's call our shots. I'm going short side cheese. Short side cheese. Oh, Gretzky never gets tired. I gotta get one of me calling my shot and then you just play the one that I hit. Miss all the other ones.
Oh.
Top right. Oh. You think you're one of the best fighters in NHL history? I've missed the net every time. Top 8 all time. Has anyone ever been better at defense in a single season than you that year? I've literally missed the net every single time except one. Best loose ball guy of all time? Yeah, Barnacle! Gino! That's cheese!
After practice, it's time for the official team photo.
Reset. Well, I think you just got to keep moving forward, really. Like when we break down the tape, it's just get back to work and, you know, try to instill in those guys that we're a good group, we're a confident group, and we just got to keep playing. I'm a believer the dam's going to break. I also thought at times we were really good in some of the things we wanted to do. We just, again, not having to be great, but be solid and just continuing to work.
For us, we're in playoff mode. Like if we don't win tonight, we're done. So there's a lot of motivation, obviously, to play well in front of our home crowd, but also we got to win or go home on the other end. So I think for us, it's just managing the game and making sure that, you know, we kind of dictate the play and we make sure that if they go on a run, that we stop it and we can get on a run of our own.
When expectation becomes desperation and stakes become pressure, the team has no choice but to formulate a response that matches the gravity of the occasion.
You're doing what's right and sacrificing and doing something for the guy next to you. There's a guy over there who's working his ass to get back in the lineup. Right? There's a guy over there who doesn't complain ever. We got guys all over this room that pull on the rope, whether they're in or out. Today, tonight, we are all in. We are all in. Right from that opening faceoff, we stick together, we work together, and we win together. Get your hand in the middle. Get your hand in the middle, and let's do a job. Win on three. 1, 2, 3.
On the strike, Mike Messinger and Tyrell Hammer Jackson. Returning ball is down, and we are underway in Zestel Center. Boudreaux runs it up 3-on-2. Matthew short side scores. The mailman paints the top corner green. And Saskatchewan.
first half ends with the Rush up 2.
Do your job, do it well. Okay? And we pick each other up, we pick each other up. What an opportunity. It's going to take every single one of us, and it's going to be worth it. Okay? And again, like when we were little, don't forget it's got to be fun. Okay? It's fun when the guy sprints off the floor for you. You know that, right? It's fun when you have a guy who supports you when you're f***ing playing defense. It's fun when a guy sets a f***ing pick for you. It's fun when guys turn the corner. It's fun watching the mailman come off the bench and play it shift by shift. Okay? 5 minutes at a time. All right? We're on our toes. Heads up here. Finish a f***ing job. Finish a f***ing job.
The second half begins just as the first ended, with the offense rolling on all cylinders.
Tight, Scanlon's caught defense, Barnable scores! The bouncer from Barney in Saskatchewan, back up by 2! Mark Walter up for Mark Matthews, Walter, over to Matthews and he scores! Mark Matthews has got the hat trick, and Saskatchewan up by 3! The Harvard product got stopped. Church has it back. Over to Walter and he scores! Sparky snipes and Saskatchewan's up by 5.
The Warriors did have an answer, pushing the critical game to overtime. Every overtime ends with a hero. This time, he wore green and black. With their playoff hopes still alive, the Rush fly to Georgia on Masters Week to visit the Swarm. Having won 6 of their last 7, the Swarm are arguably the hottest team in all of the NLL.
Conduct ourselves and carry ourselves through the good and the bad this year has been unbelievable, and that's going to continue today. Because I stand in this room and like there is not one place I would rather be in this moment right now than standing in here, getting to go into that game with this group. The last and most important thing is just remember how much work it takes and how it's always worth it. It's always worth it. That feeling we have had on many occasions this year, when we've went out and executed and done what we want, we've got the result we wanted, you can never fake that. You can never replicate that. You gotta go out and earn it. That's what we do. So we strap on our helmets, hey, we get on our toes, and we're out the door, and we don't look back. It's our night, it starts right now, on our feet.
It feels like a playoff game in Georgia. Thanks for joining us on a Saturday night in Gaston's Arena. The Saskatchewan Rush, 6-8 on the season, take on the Georgia Swarm, exact same record. Matthews down for Church. Robert Church, OT winner against Vancouver Medronics, and Tycrease Dive scores! Austin Medronic, the Harvard product, gets Saskatchewan on the board with their first of the evening.
Any momentum from Robert Church's OT winner was stifled by an explosive Swarm start. They went up 6-1 in the first quarter.
Robert Church now off the bench, far side scores. Who needs bar down Bobby when you can whip it low to low, and Saskatchewan's cut the lead down to 3.
I'll be real simple and honest here. To start the game, they're all outworked. That is uncontrollable. Offensively, we need to move our feet when we catch the ball. We've got 30 minutes here, but we play it shift by shift, 1 minute at a time. Every single one of us and push a little harder. Okay, on our toes. Ready? Yeah. You ready?
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
pick for Church out in front, and it's in the back. The net is Marty Dinsdale. Welcome back, Marty. The lead's down to three. Now Jared Smith's in a foot race. Jared Smith wants to run feed for Robert Church, and tight, and he scores. Far down, Bobby buries his fourth of the evening.
With Bouquet pulled for a break, Sask product Lane Rushka made his season debut, recording his first save of the season.
Georgia happy to kill some clock. Lyle Thompson, one-on-one. Pass over to Shane Jackson, stopped by Rushka. A huge save by the Saskatchewan product.
This time, the uphill climb was too steep, and the Rush's second-half comeback never fully materialized. To keep their playoff hopes alive, the Rush are left with one choice, to win. But to choose to win is not the same as the execution of it. It takes an extraction of our very best, a reimagination of our capabilities, a propulsion of our will. To go from the outside of the playoff picture to the inside is the entire goal, the only goal. Now is the time to take it.
That's it. Mindset is it's still possible, and that's all we need, right? You know, it's never say die, and all we can do is focus one game at a time, and it starts tonight. And once we get going, like, we're right in the game, and like, if we're starting the second quarter 2-2, I think that game goes completely different, right? So we just kind of start on time, and that's kind of what our coaches have been telling us all night. Every game's been really tight, usually comes down to the last minute, and I think it's going to be a pretty exciting game. They're looking for playoff push, and so are we, so everything's going to be left on the floor.
Sometimes all a team needs is a little funk, and the Rush brought all of it to Retro Night at Co-op Field. Reinforcement returning to the lineup, forward Marty Dinsdale.
It was a long road, you know, missed a few games, but it's really nice to get back in the lineup. Yeah, I mean, we got to put together a full 60, which is much easier said than done. You know, I think we've had bad starts to some recent games that we lost, so I think that's going to be a big thing for us tonight, is that first quarter and trying to get a few early.
What we have in front of us, when you put it in the grand scheme of things, it ain't that hard. We just got to make the choice right now, when we walk out that door, that we are going to do every single thing we can to put ourselves in the best position possible to win the game. Because the opportunities we get tonight, and the opportunities we get every single night, and the opportunities you get in life, they always come through hard work. So we owe it to the people in this room to go out there and to do whatever it takes. Because our season, our lives are on the line.
The start of this one was all rough.
Fighter save made, rebound scored. Your chance, Saskatchewan. Clark Walter draws first blood.
While the team were singing the anthems, or both the anthems, sorry.
Robert Church drives and scores. Short side snipe for Robert Church, who's got 44 on the year.
He's only a couple away from a big milestone tonight. This is going to go a long way in getting here. We were singing.
He's got Lindner off the bench. Dan Lindner to the net, and he scores.
But just as everything was rolling, Bouquet would exit the game with an apparent foot injury, clearing the cage for Eric Penny. would enter the break up 6-4.
We'll get to where we want to get to, but we're not there yet. And don't kid yourself thinking that we're there, because we're not. We got a whole lot more to give. We are going to come out this door, and we are going to do even more than we did in that first half. We're going to play for every single person in this room, and we're going to go finish the job.
Wild turnout. Short side scores. The sneaky slider, and Clark Walter has his second of the game.
Love the play by Clark Walter.
As Garland with Barnable fires and scores. Ryan Barnable runs it in from Whitby and blasts one off the post and in. Saskatchewan's got nine.
The rush broke.
They hold a 3-goal lead heading into the most important fourth quarter of their season, but the Halifax Thunderbirds had different plans.
Whether you're here or you're somewhere else or you're going through life, you got to remember that you got to get better from these, because they will be the ones that build the character. And I know that probably doesn't mean much right now, but really it is. So stick together, keep your heads high. We got a season to finish.
The hunt for the playoffs may be over, but the season is not. For a team that no longer has postseason aspirations, all that's left to do is play until you've made a statement. Play until you've made your mark. This is Inside the Rush.